And so on to unit 2. So we talked about electricity and energy in the home. Now we talk about energy associated with moving goods and services. And here's another one of my really poor drawings. And that is supposed to be a car. So I don't know which way is forward or backwards, but we'll stick the exhaust on this end. And of course, this exhaust is where a number of our emission challenges come in. It's also the same with electricity generation, of course. So here at the back, I'm getting carbon dioxide. I'm getting VOCs, which stands for volatile organic compounds. I'm getting some particulates. Soot, if it happens to be a diesel engine, will be particularly problematic. And so we have a number of these challenges. These, of course, are going to go in and contribute to smog. I would call smog ground level ozone. And many other environmental challenges. So we're talking about how we move goods and services around. We're talking about the type of things that we actually put into the vehicle. So that's supposed to be a fuel cap. Of course, we've got good old gasoline. You may notice I have an accent, so I like to think it's called petrol. It was in France, it's called benzene. We add now ethanol into the system. Ethanol. As well as being a mix, there is, of course, diesel and biodiesel. And, of course, the bio equivalent going in as well. So we have a combination of both fossil fuels, this is all oil-derived, as well as biomass derived for my ethanol and my biodiesel. We also have vehicles that are fired with methane, and we also have electric, which relates back to unit 1. So how do we get all these components? Well, somewhere along the way there is a very big refinery, cracking tower, distillation tower. Distillation tower, we get various different cuts coming out depending on their boiling points. We do a bunch of different processing and mixing and blending to get the various final cuts we want, whether that is gasoline, jet fuel, diesel, items like that. Of course, we have to get this out of the ground as well, so part of the discussion is how do we do that? And of course, we like to drill down. We now have some nice horizontal type of drilling activity that we can do, which makes it for a small wellhead pad. And of course, this might be Marcellus shale, might be oil, might be gas. And so we have some sort of means of pulling this out or letting it flow out. There is a pipeline that goes and weaves its way somewhere into the refinery setup. So all about transportation, fuel choices, as well as this mess, which is supposed to be the processing of the fuels as well as the extraction.